still let's create data entry form without hassle. No need to have macro or maybe VBA required. How we are going to perform it? Let's take a look at.
All right, welcome to the screen, guys. This is the basic data set I do have, right? So I have just added the column, and now I need to add the data consecutively in this particular columns, right? So how we are going to perform? Now I'll click on the file, and then there is an option called options, right? Into the files. Now you need to click on the quick access toolbar, and then over here need to click on all commands, okay? I'll show you what I did once again. I was on the general tab. I clicked on the quick access toolbar. Now, okay, if you are not able to find on popular command, you need to click on the all commands. Okay, here now click on the all commands. Now search for the forms. Okay, you will find it. Now just press the F button from my keyboard. Okay, so I'm searching for that particular option. And here you go, okay, and then I'll just add it. Okay, now you can see there is an option, right? Default and the workbook one. So this workbook is basically, that's my workbook which is open currently, and the default one, the option will always show me whichever workbook I do open that time. Okay, now I'll press the OK button. You can see a customized ribbon has been added in the top. Okay, I just select the range and I've just clicked on the customize button. Now click on the OK. Okay, just add the details as per your requirement. And again, team, you know, you can change your fields, headings, whatever as per your requirement, right? I've just put this as in a reference for the, you know, I can show you the details. I'm just adding the details consecutively, okay? And this is the number basically, and again this is just in a raw details. You can add your details, that's fine, as per your requirement. Name, employee ID. So this will help you to know, create a data entry form kind of thing. Okay, again, for employee database tracker you can do it, or maybe any client sheet you have, right? And you need to perform it like in this way, you can do it. There is no need to have any kind of macros or VBA in place, friends. You can directly do it your own. Okay, just do it, new record, you can add it consecutively, right? Now you can see, if you delete this particular entry, you can directly restore it as well. Okay, there is an option called restore. Okay, new restore, and criteria, if you want to add some kind of a criteria, you can do that as well. Okay, I'll not push this video particular much, because this is what I want to demonstrate to you guys. So let me add one more detail over here, so I can, you know, show you few of the option over here. Correct, find previous. Okay, this will help you find next, and then delete this entry. You can delete it, and form, or maybe criteria. If you want to add some criteria, right, if there is an age criteria, you can add it and search it accordingly, whatever details you are adding on that particular form. Okay, so this is all I had for this tutorial. So please subscribe us on YouTube, Discover Talent 143, and you can also search us on search engine Discover Talent Presents. Thank you.